Hello, fellow YouTubers. I've been asked by a few users to give more details to my barrel composting garden that I created and have a few training videos. So I had to devise a template to make for this in order to bring some clarity as to how I did it. I mean, my first times were experiments, and as you keep building them, you get perfected as to what you do or more refined. What you're seeing here is actually 8.5, 11 sheets. I had to improvise and use what was available to me in the apartment here. And I laid them out on the floor after measuring the drum. So the drum is actually 36 inches in height exactly. So what I did is I lined up a strip of paper, a set of 8.5, 11 papers all the way around so that I can get a full circumference of the drum, which is approximately 33.5 inches. So what you're seeing here is literally this, which the drum, this will slip on top of the drum. So that's what you're looking at. And the reason it's flat is because once I made this tube around my drum nice and snug, but not so tight that you can't slip it on and off again for creating more drums, if that makes sense. And what I've done is once I had my tube and it's nice and stable, everything is taped and it's a solid piece, I folded it in half by being very careful to align my bottoms nice and neat and folded perfectly in half. So I now have a good flat, stable area to make a template. From that point, what I did is I measured the halfway point, which was 36 3/4. So there's my halfway point. And I create a line staggered coming up and down. Each pocket distance here is 5 inches and they're staggered, nice and even going across. And each pocket themselves is 5 inches, sorry, across. And that's where you'll be cutting off your jigsaw and inserting a wine bottle or some sort of slippery, smooth neck bottle like. Might as well grab one. I found these work great because of the slope. Once your plastic is heated with a heat gun or a torch, this will just slip in perfectly and you just let it sit in there on a 45 degree angle, which you will see in other videos on how I make these. This template will give you a total of 48 pockets on this barrel drum. And you can plant on top, obviously. My previous models had 54, but for convenience and symmetry, I find that this template here is going to work better for everyone. So I hope this adds some clarity to that. It's just a matter of measuring. If you want to know some details on how I measured it, once again, I measured it in half. And from there, I measured 5 inches, did a niche 5 inches, lines at every 5, and I used my straight edge to draw lines across. And then in the center, obviously, I went halfway, which was my 36 3/4. And I start to create these lines of at each section here, nice and even all the way across. You'll figure it out as you go along. Once this is done, what's a good way to actually get the opposite side done without you having to draw all the way across is quite literally to use a very ingenious device. So you know what the other side is supposed to look like as to where to drill your holes, and that is a safety pin. Once you make all your lines, you literally take it and you go right across to the opposite side. And wherever you have a little poke in your paper is where you're going to be creating your drill hole on your barrel. Once you have your first set of drill holes, it's going to be pretty straightforward to do multiple drums and use this template for future drums if you so decide. This adds to quick manufacturing processes as far as I'm concerned. So I'm still evolving this design, but this right here, I think I'm going to use this 48 pocket template for all my future drums that I do. And hope this added a bit of clarity. The next videos, I'm actually going to recreate the series on how I actually manufactured these drums from scratch. That as much detail as possible, so there's no issues to anybody who does this. As this is a creative process, it takes, you know, you learn as you go along and you evolve. So hopefully this helps. Next video to come, which will be slipping this on the drum and then starting the drilling process. Stay tuned. As you can see, the drum is wobbly, so I want to make sure the front and back would be at the same height. Clearly, where I made my lines, I can now just start to drill. Probably better if you take one row at a time and drill around, that way you're not going to miss any holes. It gives you a form of alignment. Continue this process all the way around. Okay, so I've just finished the production of drilling the holes into the first drum here, which created the holes that I needed in my template. Moving forward, so I can keep this template for as long as possible, I'm making sure it's level to the ground, and I'm going to tape up so at least stays in the same spot. And instead of drilling again and further damaging the template, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to use my marker and make my way all the way around. Starting here. If you can hear the sounds in the background, we live in an apartment complex that is very, very cool. And what you're hearing at 7 o'clock ritual here, dealing with Corona time, is everybody's getting outside and drumming with whatever apparel they can. Some people's pots and pans, others it's real drums. I was using my suitcase because it was the best thing that made sound. It's one quick way to just deal with the lockdown situation here in Victoria, BC. As you can see, it's much faster doing it this way, and I'm not damaging the template any further. Bring up the COVID-19 and the lockdown thing. I personally have noticed some very strange behaviors. I understand it's good to keep away, but from people and the social distancing thing, but some people take it way too far, attitude-wise. And made me coin a line, SDD, social distancing disease. People are a little just too fearful here. Enough said about that. I'm just keeping up with this right here to make sure I go all the way around. This is kind of my quick little guide. You can see, let's do it in time lapse now.